Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss UGC NET previous year questions from electronic science. So a quick discussion of 5 questions. So 5 questions from electronic science. Those are from previous year questions. So let us start our discussion with the question number 5. So the question number 5 is, the Hartley oscillator is commonly used in radio receivers, radio transmitters, TV receivers and microwave transmitters. So I will give 30 seconds time. Try to answer this one. So whether the Hartley oscillator is used in radio receivers, radio transmitters, TV receivers and microwave transmitters. So generally the Hartley oscillator is a device that generates oscillatory output. So it consists of an amplifier. The Hartley oscillator consists of an amplifier and that is linked to an oscillatory circuit. So here the oscillatory circuit is nothing but LC tank circuit, L and C tank circuit. So generally the LC oscillators are used for radio frequency range. The LC oscillators are used for radio frequency range. So the answer, so here the option number D is the microwave transmitters. So microwave transmitters are nothing but the high frequency range. So the option D is eliminated. So the remaining are radio receivers, radio transmitters and TV receivers. So here the answer for this question is the radio receivers. The Hartley oscillators are generally used in radio receivers. The next question is question number 4. So the question number 4 is, the ripple factor of an half wave rectifier is, so 1.57, 1.21, 1.12 and 1.41. So generally the rectifiers are the devices which are used to convert the AC signal into the DC signal. So in power supply we are having mainly 3 components: rectifiers, filters and regulators. The rectifiers will convert the AC signal into the AC signal is nothing but the continuous signal. So the rectifiers will convert the AC signal into the pulsating DC, and the next component is the filter. The filter will convert the pulsating DC into some ripple content DC, and the regulator will convert this ripple content DC into the pure DC. So the rectifiers are classified into 2 types, full wave rectifier and half wave rectifier. In full wave rectifier again we are having the bridge type and center tapped full wave rectifier. So the ripple factor indicates how much ripple content will be there at the output of the rectifier. So at the output of the rectifier we need to get the DC component, but instead of DC component it will be added with some AC. That AC component is called as the ripple content. So the ripple factor indicates how much AC is added at the output of the rectifier. So for half wave rectifier the value is 1.12 and for the full wave rectifier the value of the ripple factor is 0.48. Next comes the question number 3. So here the question number 3 is, the current in a Zener diode is controlled by, option A is Zener diode resistance, potential barrier, impact ionization and external circuit resistance. So the answer for this one is external circuit resistance. The current in a Zener diode is generally used as the voltage regulator. So the current in a Zener diode is generally controlled by the external circuit resistance. So the next question is, sorry. Question number one. So the question number one is, semiconductor materials are made up of metallic bond, ionic bond, covalent bond, and van der Waals bond. So here the covalent bond is nothing but it indicates the sharing of atom, sharing of electrons between the two atoms, and the van der Waals forces are nothing but the these are weak forces that are dependent on the distance between the atoms or molecules. So the semiconductor materials are made up of metallic bond or ionic bond or van der Waals bond or covalent bond. So the van der Waals bonds is nothing but weak interactions caused by momentary changes in the electron density of the molecule. So here the answer for this one is the covalent bond, and this figure represents the van der Waals bond. So these are the weak interactions caused by the momentary changes in the electron density of the molecule, and this will represent the covalent bond. That means this is the hydrogen atom and the carbon atom, so both are benefited by sharing their electrons. And the next one is the metallic bonding. So the generally the semiconductor materials are made up of covalent bond. So the next question is question number 2. So here the UJT has negative resistance characteristics, low firing current, bipolar device, and relax indefinitely. So the UJT is the unijunction transistor. It is used as the relaxation oscillator. So what is the characteristic of this UJT? So the answer for this question is the negative resistance characteristics. So generally the UJT is the electronic semiconductor device that has only one p-n junction within n-type or lightly doped ohmic channel. The UJT has three terminals, emitter, base 1 and base 2. And one more important question from the UJT is, generally the UJT is used intrinsic standoff ratio of the UJT. So the value of intrinsic standoff ratio for the UJT is 0.4 to 0.8. So thank you for your attention. Hope you are getting some knowledge about the question. Thank you.